Welcome to our next session. I think you all are using the mobile phones to write your notes and everything, is it? And you are continuously watching your subjects. So, those who are using the mobile phones to write the notes and watching the classes, make the brightness to reduce in your phone or else put it into reading mode. Okay, students? So, if you are increasing the brightness of your mobile phone, means it will reduce your battery and it will affect your eyes. So, make sure that you are using your mobile phone in less amount of time. So, maximum you can use your mobile phones to watch your videos at maximum to 20 minutes. And again, keep away the mobiles for 20 minutes and again you can use your mobiles for studying the subjects. Clear, students? So I think you are going to follow this and also practice the meditation daily. We are doing in our school while you in the class. So at least do the meditation for 5 minutes too. Clear, students? It will give a good health effect. So you know what are the advantages of doing the meditations. So try to follow the contents. Clear? So let's start our next session or next topic. This is the last topic in your first chapter. So I think you are remembering the last topic, is it? So what are they? Yes. To creating a poster, you have to use the image editing options. That is, you are using the different selection tools. The one tool you have studied mainly is Select by Color tool, is it? What is the use of that Select by Color tool? Yes, some of you are saying that. Yes, clear, correct. That is to select a part of an image according to the color of the image. Is it? Yes. So next we have studied about the layers. Layers, why we are using the layers in an image editing software? Yes, to arrange the images, or you have to edit the images, means you can use it at any time using the layers option. Clear, students? So another selection tool you can use in an image editing software is path tools. What is a path tool? By the name, can you identify? Yes. Using the path tool, you can select an image according to the size or a shape of the image. Can you get? Yes. According to the image size or which one you have to select the particular part of an image, you are using the path tools. So why we are using that? You can select a part of an image according to a fixed shape. And next is how you can use, and you can create different patterns of images using the path tools. So let's see what are that. So like this, by the node selection you can use your path tools. Can you see that in the first picture? According to the shape of that image, you can use that path tool and you can select the each and every section of a image, and you can copy and paste into a particular canvas or a poster. Can you get it? And here you can again select the images in another canvas. Clear? So let's see what is the step you can use the path tool. So we know that open the gym and you are creating a canvas, and like that you are applying the background color, is it? These are the steps to create a particular poster. And select the path tool from the toolbox. It is in a pen shape. You can see the following video which I am giving practical explanations. Clear, students? And click on edges of each and every picture like this. You can, each and every point you can select the images. And finally, press the control key in the last section of the selection. So it will be selecting, and press the enter key, you will get a selection line in the dotted line, it will be displaying in the image. You can see in the practical video. Okay, so first you are selecting the path tool and clicking on the edges, which type of size or which shape you have to use. You can select the edges and you can press the control key, and it will be selected the whole area which you have selected. Clear? Clear, students? So this is the use of a path tool. This is the another selection tool you are going to study in this chapter. Clear? After the selection, what we have to do? After the selection, we are copying the images to canvas. Is it? So from the path tool, you are marking the portion and finally right click in the option edit. You are getting the option copy and take the picture to your canvas by selecting the option paste. Is it? And you can adjust the size of the image according to the poster and or a canvas in your gym. So how to do that? Using the scale tool, you can use the size. How to adjust the size in a poster? The image, you can adjust the size. Is it? Yes. And next is, after pasting the pictures on your canvas according to poster topic, you have to adjust its color and size. Sometimes you need to adjust with another images. So how to change the picture clarity and its brightness and everything? So you have an option again. To change the picture clarity, you have to go to colors menu. In that you will get to the option brightness and contrast. What is the word contrast? It is to increase its color availability of your picture, or reduce, you can reduce the color of that particular picture. And again, what is the brightness? The clarity of a picture. In mobile also you are increasing the light or the brightness. Why it is? To see its clarity. Is it? So that's the option. In the colors option, you are getting the option in this to adjust the brightness and contrast. And you can move the slider until you get a window to adjust its amount of brightness and contrast. Clear, students? And next is, if you need to adjust any picture using some filter tool, means it is available in the gym window. How to use that? So you have a selection tool in this, and you have a filters in gym window. You can use in that. You have a blur option. You can use any different type of blur options in filter menu. In gym window, you can see a filter menu in that. You can choose the option blur. You have different type of filter options. In that, you can select blur and you can adjust the filter effect. You know, in a picture editing software, in mobiles also you are using different filters effect, is it? Yes. So these are the things we are studying in this chapter, to how to copy the images, how to copy an images in a canvas using different selection tool and different options like select by color tool, path tools, rectangle selection, circle tool, like this, is it? And next is, how to use the layers in an image editing software. In Adobe Photoshop also, these are the contents which is available in image editing. So, if you study this GIMP image editing software, means it is easy to study the Adobe Photoshop also. In every image editing software, it is available. Same continuum. So, these are the things we have studied using different filter effects, adjusting the contrast and brightness for an image, like this. Clear? Last class we have discussed about how to use a select by color tool and how to copy paste the logo into your canvas. So now we are going to look into that, how to copy a picture or a part of a picture for your poster creation using path tools. So I have told you that how to use the path tool. You can use a node by node selection or in any form, is it? So let's see how to select. So for a poster creation, you have to use a number of pictures, is it? And number of images in a different size. So we have discussed about how to use the layers and everything. So first of all, just you open a canvas. And I am selecting a particular size from the template and click OK. You will get a
canvas here, and next just apply a color. I am using a gradient tool. Choose any color. For a poster you can apply, and select the blend tool to fill the color. Okay, so your canvas is ready. Now the first layer is background, and next is you are going to insert an image. So for that, first we are going to insert an image. For that, open an image. It will be displaying as a separate window. We know that, is it? So select the picture from the folder. I am selecting the picture from your folder, that is, and here I am selecting a picture related to global warming. Okay, and next I am going to use the path tool. Here it is, paths tool. You can use a point by point selection, that is known as nodes. Each point in that. Okay, so click on that point, it will be selecting. So related to each design, you can, you know what means, just maximize it. Okay, the particular size you can select. So just select the portion which you have to choose according to your topic which you need. Okay, this is the node, the path you can select, a particular point you can select. And finally, just click the control key, it will be selected, and press the enter key, the particular part is marked, and just right click, select the option copy, and go to your canvas, choose a new layer, then only you can use the image at any time if you need to edit, and just select the layer. Copy that and paste. So the selected part is displayed now. Can you see that? Yes. So just move according to your poster. If you need to change the size, means just scale it. Or if you need to flip the image, means you have another tool, flip tool. Where it is? Yes, here. So it will be change the position into the mirror images, you can see in that. That is the use of flip tool. And you are arranging the picture. So can we arrange one more picture using that? Yes. Go to background. Just open another image. I'm closing this. How to open an image? Yes, file, open, and select another one. Here I am going to choose this options, think global and act local, like that. So again choose that path tool, click on the portions which you need. Just for an example I am showing this So according to your questions and the poster creation, you can use. Any type of selections, and so now it is selected. Right click, copy, and paste it in your canvas. Before pasting, you have to use your new layer. Can you remember that? Why we are using that layers? Yes, correct. So whenever you need to edit, you can use the images. Right click, paste. Okay, now you can see that. So like this, you can use any type of images and any size of images for an image editing option. So I need to just blur this image. How to do that? So select the image layer, select the part. The image is selected now, is it? So I have to blur the images. So here, go to the option, tools, so next we have to check how to adjust the contrast and brightness of a picture. Like that you can adjust in a poster editing process. So go to colors option. You will get the option brightness and contrast. If you need to reduce the contrast of the background color, means that is just select the background, go to color, brightness and contrast. Here you can adjust the values here. If you need to reduce the brightness, means here, contrast means, so it will change the effect. Okay, can you see that? Using this slide, you can adjust the values. So I have reduced the brightness and contrast. And next is you can apply the different filters too. You know the filters in an image editing software. You are using your mobile phones, is it? Different effects on an image you can apply, is it? So go to filters. If you need to blur the particular option, means you can use. So I'm selecting the second layer of that. I need to blur the image. So go to that particular layer, go to filters and blur. You can select any type of blur option. I am choosing the focus blur. Just apply. You can select any type of styles. So you can see the blurred image on your canvas. So these are the main contents which you have to study in this first chapter. That is, how can we edit an image using GIMP software, or you can create a poster or a collage work using GIMP. Clear, students? So these are the main activities we have discussed in the first chapter. So we'll see you with the example questions on the next class. Okay, children?
Clear? So I hope you have understood the contents in image editing software, and everyone is following the contents whichever I am giving the classes, and all you are submitting your works to. So with a new topic and new activity, I'll see you in the next class. So please remember what I have said before. Use your mobile phones in less amount of time. Control the brightness and make it in a reading mode while you are writing the contents. Clear, students? So we'll see you in the next class.